We are now witnessing the dawn of the Starship V2 era. Several systems on board Starship have undergone substantial modifications to address the challenges faced during version 1 development, most notably the extreme one, 500 degrees Celsius temperatures experienced during re-entry. Among these systems, the wing flaps have emerged as a particularly important focal point. Equipped with cutting-edge design and advanced technology, the Starship V2 wing flaps are poised to surpass previous limitations and achieve incredible feats. What improvements have been made to the Starship wing flaps? Join us as we dive into the specifics in today's episode of NR Studio. SpaceX has set 2025 as a pivotal year, marking the arrival of the highly anticipated Starship V2. The expedition kicked off with Flight 7, which showcased the S33 and B1 prototypes. B1 retained the V1 design, while S33 introduced the V2 model, which featured significant modifications, particularly to the flap system that has garnered much attention. Before exploring the improvements, it's important to understand the rationale behind the need for these modifications. The V1 flaps are distinguished by their rugged and robust design, characterized by uniform edges. Both the front and rear flaps follow this established pattern. The front flaps are positioned symmetrically on either side of the nose cone at 180-degree angles, which are joined to the craft via joints, creating small but significant gaps. This design showed a marked vulnerability during re-entry, a phase that exposes the spacecraft to extreme temperatures reaching 1,500 degrees Celsius. During the flight, for example, the front flap suffered significant damage, nearly detaching from the craft. Although subsequent flights showed some improvement, persistent small fires near the flaps underscored the need for a more durable solution. Musk himself recognized this challenge as early as 2021, saying, "Well, by the way, there's a small problem with the four-flap design. The inclusion of a movable section is essential for effective control. However, the passive section proved counterproductive, as it tended to slide the nose backward. This highlighted an intrinsic flaw in the design that needed to be resolved to meet the daunting challenges of re-entry." Introducing Starship V2, where SpaceX has made significant improvements to the flap system, directly addresses this challenge with determination. A significant alteration can be observed in the dimensions and configuration of the forward flaps. In contrast to their V1 predecessors, the newly designed forward flaps exhibit a decrease in both size and thickness, resulting in a more compact and considerably lighter structure. These optimizations enhance the functionality of the flap while simultaneously reducing the overall mass of the spacecraft, a factor that is crucial for efficiency. Furthermore, the contour of the forward flaps has undergone refinement. The edges have been refined to a sharper profile, potentially improving aerodynamic control in flight. The connection between the flaps and the ship has been enhanced, effectively eradicating the vulnerable gaps identified in the V1 design. This cohesive framework reduces vulnerabilities and bolsters the spacecraft's durability during re-entry. Although the dimensions and contours of the aft flaps appear mostly unchanged, it is probable that they have experienced a reduction in thickness to diminish their overall mass. These enhancements collectively yield a more efficient and streamlined system. A significant enhancement in V2 is the strategic realignment of the flaps. In 2021, Musk alluded to this modification, indicating that the updated design would involve an enhanced rotation of the forward flaps, directing them more towards the leeward side and positioned further forward to optimize the moment arm, potentially aligning them approximately 120 degrees apart. This alteration signifies that the forward flaps have lost their symmetry and are no longer set at a 180-degree angle. Instead, they are now positioned at an angle ranging from 120 to 10 degrees on the ship's leeward side. This strategic realignment safeguards the flaps from the intense heat of re-entry, thereby alleviating the damage and combustion issues that affected the V1 models. This groundbreaking modification tackles one of the foremost obstacles encountered by spacecraft during re-entry and may establish a new benchmark for the industry. Moreover, the forward flaps have been repositioned nearer to the vehicle's apex. This modification amplifies their impact, particularly in the realm of the ship's navigation during the landing phase, thereby enhancing both control and precision. Conversely, the aft flaps maintain their initial position due to their performance exhibiting relative stability at V1. These collective modifications have not only addressed prior issues, but also fostered enhanced reliability, streamlined manufacturing processes, and augmented payload capacity. Musk's optimism regarding these enhancements was palpable in his remarks upon the completion of the new V2 nose cone, which features redesigned flaps, as he conveyed his sense of relief. "I am quite pleased that we have successfully resolved the issues with the forward flap design. The previous model was a considerable burden, its size and weight were excessive, and its 180-degree orientation necessitated substantial static aerodynamic forces while not being fully retracted. This configuration inadvertently pushed the nose backward during the high thermal hypersonic phase of flight, which is counterproductive to the desired performance. Undoubtedly, the shift to Starship V2 signifies a crucial milestone in SpaceX's trajectory. By rectifying the deficiencies in the flap design and implementing cutting-edge solutions, the company is paving the way for unprecedented advancements in space exploration. Flight 7 and the inaugural launch of S33 mark merely the inception of this new era, heralding a future where the boundaries of spacecraft architecture are fundamentally transformed. Now is the opportune moment to evaluate those enhancements. Commencing with Flight 7, are you eager to explore the capabilities of the new flaps? Please indicate your enthusiasm with a simple yes in the comments section below. Subsequently, please show your appreciation by liking the video, subscribing to the channel, and remaining engaged with us to stay informed about SpaceX's ongoing development journey. As we prepare for Flight 7, attention is notably focused on the performance of the flaps, which stands out as one of the mission's most highly anticipated aspects. In a recent flight update, SpaceX elucidated the enhancements, indicating that a series of planned upgrades to the Starship upper stage will be showcased in this flight test, resulting in significant advancements in both reliability and performance. The vehicle's forward flaps have been minimized in size and repositioned towards the tip, distancing them from the heat shield. This adjustment considerably lessens their exposure to re-entry heating, while also streamlining the associated mechanisms and protective tiling. These advancements in forward flap design constitute a significant progression in the optimization of Starship's overall architecture. As per SpaceX's assertions, the novel design offers two principal advantages. To begin with, streamlining the fundamental mechanisms significantly improves the vehicle's navigation abilities. A streamlined design minimizes potential failure points and enhances operational efficiency, thereby facilitating more accurate adjustments during flight. Moreover, the revised flaps streamline the heat shield tile configuration. By relocating the flaps away from the heat shield, SpaceX has minimized the necessity for intricate, diminutive tiles and challenging coverage zones. This enhancement not only facilitates manufacturing and installation procedures, but also significantly simplifies tile replacement in instances of damage. This advancement facilitates a more thorough safeguarding of the flaps, thereby augmenting their durability under the extreme circumstances of re-entry. In Flight 7, the quartet of flaps, alongside the comprehensive flap system, will be integral to the successful attainment of the mission's objectives. A notable aspect of this flight's ambitious agenda includes the deployment of simulated Starlink satellites. This represents the inaugural occasion on which SpaceX will endeavor such a deployment utilizing Starship, necessitating sophisticated navigation skills to adeptly maneuver in space and accurately deploy the payload. Accomplishing this task would set a foundational precedent for Starship to transport and deploy actual payloads in subsequent missions, marking a significant milestone in SpaceX's overarching vision for the rocket. The second primary objective of Flight 7 entails directing Starship to perform a precise vertical landing in the ocean. Although SpaceX has successfully accomplished this task in prior missions, the complexity may be heightened on this occasion. For example, Starship might employ a more pronounced attack angle or execute supplementary maneuvers prior to its descent. While SpaceX's previous experience indicates a strong likelihood of success, this mission will be pivotal in assessing the flap's performance in anticipation of the more formidable challenges that lie ahead. A forthcoming challenge includes the recovery of Starship's return to Starbase. In contrast to a brief ocean landing, a complete return to Starbase involves traversing an extended path and undergoing a more demanding re-entry procedure. Upon arriving at the launch tower, Starship will depend on the meticulous coordination of its flaps and engines to precisely descend into the supportive embrace of the chopstick's waiting arms. This capture maneuver requires exceptional precision and poses a significantly greater challenge than the retrieval of the Super Heavy booster. Nonetheless, the insights gained from the successful landings of the booster will undoubtedly enhance and reinforce SpaceX's confidence in realizing this ambitious objective. The performance of the wing flaps on Flight 7 will be a clear example of their ability to integrate with other systems within the Starship framework. An early vital integration involves the engine system. The wing flaps and engines must operate in perfect harmony to facilitate navigation and deceleration of the vehicle during landing, whether in ocean waters or at the launch tower. This partnership serves as a critical element in Starship's journey toward achieving complete reusability, a critical component of SpaceX's comprehensive long-term strategy. Another critical integration involves the heat shield system. Given that the wing flaps are some of Starship's most vulnerable elements, it is critical that the heat shield act as a robust protective barrier. This shield guides them through the intense thermal conditions associated with re-entry into the atmosphere. Effective integration of these systems will be a critical determinant of Starship's ability to survive multiple flights, increasing the practicality of SpaceX reusable spacecraft design. Flight 7 provides a valuable opportunity for SpaceX to evaluate the robustness of the enhanced systems integrated into Starship. Reports suggest that SpaceX may have intentionally reduced the number of tiles in certain areas to assess the flap's resilience to vulnerabilities. Additionally, the introduction of new metal tiles alongside advanced cooling systems will present even greater challenges for the enclosure to overcome. This flight only marks the beginning of a long journey for Starship and its upgraded enclosure. SpaceX intends to conduct more than 20 Starship flights by 2025, advancing the limits of its design and rigorously assessing its capabilities through a variety of missions. Each flight will leverage the accomplishments and insights gained from its predecessors, improving the enclosure system and other elements to achieve unprecedented levels of performance and reliability. In terms of the immediate objectives of Flight 7, the mission will serve to advance a diverse spectrum of objectives. Starship is set to serve a critical role in the establishment of SpaceX's orbital refueling system, a critical element of deep space exploration efforts. Furthermore, future flights may include uncrewed operations of the Starship Human Landing System, HLS, as part of NASA's Artemis initiative, further strengthening its position in the coming era of space exploration. As SpaceX relentlessly pushes the boundaries of innovation, the enclosure will continue to be a critical element in Starship's evolution. Having withstood temperatures exceeding 1500 degrees Celsius and performed complex maneuvers, the cover will stand as a testament to SpaceX's engineering brilliance. The journey ahead holds exciting and transformative prospects, marked by pioneering achievements and uncharted territory waiting to be explored. That's it for today's episode. See you next time.